All in this video we are going to see punctuations. So let us see these punctuation types. These are all the most commonly used punctuations. So number one, full stop, we're calling it as period, comma, apostrophe, colon and semicolon. So we are going to see the functions of these semicolons, most commonly used punctuations, that too most commonly used punctuations. So first one, full stop, period, we are calling it as. Full stops are used to mark the end of a sentence, that is a complete statement, to show that the meaning of the statement has end, has over. So we are using this full stop to show that the meaning of the statement has over within itself, right? So see the example, my name is Beth and I was 18 in July. Yes, the statement has a complete meaning. So we are using full stop. The next, after leaving school, she went to work in an insurance company. Yes, the information has got over within the sentence itself. So at last, we are using the full stop. The second usage, to mark the end of a group of words that don't form a conventional sentence. So as to emphasize a statement, you are sometimes saying a statement, an information, and to emphasize the same statement, you are using some more words, some another sentence which does not give a proper meaning. At that time also, we are using this full stop. See the example, I keep relieving the moment. Yes, it has got over, full stop we have put. Again, we are going to emphasize the same sentence by giving some more, some another statement. So over and over again. So, but if you are seeing this over and over again, it doesn't give any full-fledged meaning. If you are seeing this over and over again, alone, this class alone. But this is a statement which emphasizes the previous statement. So conventional statement. So at the time also, we are using this full stop. First thing is, we are using this full stop to show that the meaning of the sentence has over within the sentence itself. So at the time, we are using this full stop. Again, the second usage is when you are using some more statement, some another statement to emphasize the previous statement, at the time you have to put full stop for the previous statement also and this emphasizing statement also. And the next usage is in some abbreviations, we are using this full stop. For example, C, D, E, C or P, M. Whenever you are using, you are shortening a word in the sense, at the time you have to use this full stop. Right, see, there's a wide range of sandwiches, pies, cakes, etc. So, etc., we are shortening that etc. as ETC. Okay, so, at the time, we are using this full stop at very reasonable price. So, most of the time, we are using abbreviations with this full stops. And the next one, in websites and email addresses, we are using. See, for example, www.oup.com. So, these web addresses, we are using this full stops. So these are all the usages where we are using these full stops. If an abbreviation with a full stop comes at the end of the sentence, you don't need to add another full stop. If suppose see www.oup.com, you need not to use another .com. Again, you need not to put another dot, another full stop at the end. You can leave the statement with this .com itself, right? Okay. So these are the four usages of this period, this full stop. So you are using this full stop to at the end of the statement, again at the end of the emphasis statement if you are using to emphasize the previous statement, and at the whenever you are using some abbreviations and web addresses. So all these places you are using this full stop, period, right? Okay, the next one is comma. A comma marks a slight break between different parts of a sentence. Used properly, comma makes the meaning of sentences clear by grouping and separating words, phrases and clauses. So whenever you are using more than one clauses, you have to use this comma. More than one words with the same weightage, at the time you have to use this comma. So here are the main cases when you need to use a comma. List, to list indirect speech. Whenever you're using this indirect speeches, at the time you have to use this comma. To separate clauses, to separate phrases and clauses, to make of certain parts of sentences with however. So all these places you have to see, you have to use this comma. We are going to see elaborately. So using commas in lists, I already told you, listing in indirect speeches, we are using this comma. So lists, how we have to use this comma. See, you need to put a comma between the different items in the list as in the following sentence. So Saturday morning started with their hearty breakfast of scrambling eggs, bacon, sausage and French toast. So all these are the list of words having the same weightage. So comma, 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 we are using that. My favorite sandwiches are chicken, bacon, and ham and cheese. Again, all these words are having the same weightage. The listing, we are listing some words, so we are using this comma, right? Next, using commas in indirect speech. So when a writer quotes a speaker's word exactly as they were spoken, this is known as indirect speech, right? Yes, so at the time you are using this comma, usually we are using all these punctuations only in written communication, right? So whenever you are quoting exact words of the speaker, we are calling that as an indirect speech, right? So at the time we are using this comma, right? See example, Steve replied. The next we are going to quote the exact words of Steve, no problem. So at the time here, after this replied, we are using this comma. You also need to use a comma at the end of a piece of the direct speech if the speech comes before the information about who is speaking. If suppose the Steve replay, it comes the last in the sentence, you have to put comma before the Steve, right? At the end of the direct speech, for example, see in case, I don't agree. Here the speech, the direct speech comes in the beginning, and later we are quoting who have spoken the previous thing. So at the time you have to put the comma after the direct speech. I don't agree, comma, I replied. Here we are, comma, they said. So these are the places we are using this comma. The next usage, using commas to separate clauses. So you are going to quote one more clause. Phrases, you are going to add phrases, clauses, in the sense you have to use commas. See, commas are used to separate clauses in a complex sentence. Why? Because in complex sentences, we are having two clauses, main clause and subordinate clause. At the time, you have to use this comma. See, having had lunch, comma, we went back to work. I first saw her in Paris, comma, where I lived in the early 90s. Passengers who have young children may board the aircraft first. Mary, who has two children, has a part-time job in the library. So all these are complex sentences which is having more than one information and more than one clause, main clauses and subordinate clauses. So at the time, while separating main clause and subordinate clause, we have to use this comma. Using commas to mark off parts of a sentence. See, commas are used to separate a part of a sentence that is an optional aside and not part of the main statement. If it is not the part of the main statement, but you are adding some optional information there, at the time you can use this comma. For example, see, gunpowder is not, of course, a chemical compound. To stress that you are using this of course, you need not to use that. It is not necessary there, but you are using as an optional word. At the time you have to use this comma. His latest film, comma, Calypso Dreams, opens next month. Right? So here we need not to quote the name of the film, but you did it there. But with the comma, you can do it. Next, using a comma with however. So whenever you are using this however with the word as a conjunction, at the time you have to use comma. So you should not use comma. You should use a comma after however when however means by contrast or on the other hand. If the however gives the meaning on the other hand and by contrast, at the time you have to use this comma. However, a good deal of discretion is left in the hands of area managers, but you should not use this comma after however when the however means in whatever way, right? For example, see, however you look at it, whatever way you can look at, right? So exist inventors or look investors are likely to lose out. So when you are using this however as a conjunction, that however has to give the meaning of right, in contrast with, on the other hand. If the however gives the meaning in contrast, on the other hand, yes, you can use that comma, but however you are using with like in whatever meaning, at the time you should not use this comma. So these are the usages of comma. Next we are going to see apostrophe. The best way to get apostrophes right is to understand when and why they are used. So two main places we are using that. First, using apostrophes to show possession. And the next one is to show omission. Let us see here. Using apostrophes to show possession. So you use an apostrophe to show that a thing or a person belongs to you, relates to someone or something, right? At the time, you can say this, you can use that with apostrophe and S. See, instead of saying the party of Ben, the party belongs to the Ben, the party is conducted by the Ben, you can say like Ben's party, right? So apostrophe with S. Singular noun and most personal names. At the time, you have to add an apostrophe plus S. First apostrophe plus S. Singular noun and most personal names while you're owning. See, the dog's tail. The tail belonged to the dogs. The dog's tail wagged rapidly. Yesterday's weather. The weather was yesterday's one, right? Not today's weather. Yesterday's weather. So, at the time, you are mentioning that particularly with apostrophe and S. And then personal names that ends in S. So whenever a personal name that ends in S, add an apostrophe plus S. So see, he joined Charles's army. So you not you you should not use it Charles. Charles is already S is there. Why we have to use another S? You don't need to any shouldn't have any confusion like that. Whatever name ends with S also, you have to use another apostrophe and S while you are showing the possession, right? So Charles's name. Dickens' novel provide a wonderful insight into Victorian England. Right. Next usage. Plural noun that ends in S. At the time, you have to use the apostrophe like SN last apostrophe. Add an apostrophe after the S. Usually, the plural nouns comes with S only. While you are showing the possession, you have to use the apostrophe at the end of the statement. See, the end of the word after the S. The mansion was converted into a girls' hostel. Actually, it's girls' hostel. The hostel belongs to the girls, but the girls is a plural, so you have to use an apostrophe at the end of the word girls. Right? Okay. My duties included cleaning out the horses' stable. Horses' stables. So, horses is a plural, but the stables belong to the horses. So, at the time, you have to use to this apostrophe to show the possession. Right? So you have to use this apostrophe at the end of the word. Plural noun that do not end in S. Add an apostrophe plus S. He employs 14 people at his men's clothing center store. So here this men is also plural, but it doesn't come with S, right? Some of the words that don't come with S, right, to show the plural, but it is a plural word. So at the time you have to use normally S apostrophe and S. If some plural words comes with S and later you use only apostrophe at the end of the word, right? But it doesn't come with this men, women, all these words doesn't come with, all these words don't come with S. So at the time you have to use apostrophe and S. And the next one, using apostrophe is to show omission, right? To show omission is nothing but to shorten some words. At the time we are using this apostrophe also. First thing is showing possession and the next thing is showing omission. So showing possession at the time, what are the when and all we have to show this possession, what are the places how to use this apostrophe while showing this possession. First time if you are showing possession for a singular and most personal noun, add apostrophe plus S. And personal names also, if it comes with S also, you have to use this apostrophe and S. And if the plural noun comes with S, at the time you have to use only the apostrophe at the end of the word. And plural noun, it doesn't come with S, at the time you have to use this as usually apostrophe and S you have to use, like this men, women, like that. And last, to show the omission, we are shortening some words. At the time, we are using this omission. Say, for example, an apostrophe can be used to show that letters or numbers have been omitted. So, I am, right? See here, I am. Instead of saying this, I am, I apostrophe am. He'll, he will, she'd, she had or she'd. Pick in mix. This and we have shortened as in. So, apostrophe we are using here. So it's hot, it is hot, didn't, don't, shouldn't. So all these places we are omitting this N-O-T-O. So here we are using this apostrophe. So whenever you are shortening some words to omit some letters, there we are using this apostrophe. So these are the usages of apostrophe while possession and omission. Next. There are three main uses of the colon. So we are going to see here colon. between two main classes in case where the second class explains or follows from the first one. That is the secret of my extraordinary life. Always do the unexpected. And so two main classes are there, where the second class here is depending upon the first class and explains the first class, right? The main class. So the subordinate class explain the main class, the first class, in the sense at the time you have to use this colon. See, that is the secret of my extraordinary life. So that is the secret. So which is the secret? It comes in the next, right? It comes in the next. So we are using the colon. Always do the unexpected. Actually here, that gives here. Always do the unexpected is the explanation for the that. That is the secret of my extraordinary life. What is the secret? Always do the unexpected. So whenever you are using two main classes, when the second class, the upcoming class, is the part of the first class, right? At the time you have to use this colon. It wasn't easy. So which wasn't easy? To begin with, I had to find the right house. So having find the right house was not easy. Right? So at the time we have to use this colon, which is to begin with, I had to find the right house is the part of the first sentence, it, where it replaced the pronoun it there. So such places you have to use this colon. And to introduce a list, whenever you are going to introduce the list, at the time you have to use this colon. The price includes the following. Most of the time it comes with following, right? After that you have to use that colon. Travel to London, flight to Venice, hotel accommodation and excursions. So all these lists, before that you are using this following plus the colon. The job calls for skills in the following areas: proofing, editing and database administration. So at the time you are using this colon before the listing it. Before a quotation and sometimes before direct speech. Direct speech you need not to use only the comma. Most of the time you can use this comma and sometimes you can use colon also. The headline read, it is a quote, the headline read: taxi driver battles gangster. They shouted, our families are starving, we need land. Both are direct speeches. So at the time you are using this colon. You can use comma also. And the next, semicolon. The main task of the semicolon is to mark a break that is stronger than a comma but not as a final as a full stop. We are using the semicolon to show the function is more stronger than the comma but not a full stop. The sentence, the meaning of the sentence doesn't end within it, right? It is used between two main classes that balanced each other and are closely linked to be made into separate sentence. See the example. The road runs through a beautiful wooded valley. The railway lines follows it. Both are having the same weightage, right? Both are having the equal weightage of the meaning. So we are using this semicolon. An art director searched in North Africa. I went to the Canary Islands. So here also both are different informations, but like they are likely to be related, right? So at the time you are using this semicolon. So these are the punctuation marks. Again, you can also use the semicolon as a stronger division in a sentence that already contain commas. So you are going to show a bigger paragraph, right? But you are going to quote more informations having the same weightage, right? So at the time you can use the semicolon. See, the study showed the following. Usually before listing we have to put semicolon. So after following we have to put the semicolon. 76% of surveyed firms monitor employee web surfing activities, comma, with 65% blocking access to unauthorized internet locations. Over one-third of the firms monitoring employees' computer key stores. Half reported storing and reviewing employee emails. 57% monitor employees' telephone behavior, including the inappropriate use of voicemails. All these are can come with commas also and semicolons also, since it is having same weightage of informations, meanings, right? Alright, so these are all the punctuation marks and usage of what are the places we have to use those punctuation marks we have seen. So usages are very much important since our communication is mostly based on written. So this punctuation only we are using while writing only, at the time of written communication only to show the exact meaning. So if the punctuation changes, obviously the meaning itself, the stress itself has changed, completely have changed. So in written communication, the purpose of this punctuation is very much important. So kindly go through it. If you have any doubt, let me know. I'll clarify. Thank you.